The third case of coronavirus has been confirmed in Lagos. The Lagos State Ministry of Health, which confirmed the case, said the patient is unconnected with the index case. The infected, a 30-year-old Nigerian female, returned from the United Kingdom on Friday. She observed self-isolation, developed symptoms, and tested positive. And now Dr. Tsuyu Mebawondu, a public health practitioner, joins us live via phone to react to this development. Thank you, doctor, for joining us.
I can hear you.
Nigeria just confirmed another case of coronavirus a few minutes ago. What do you make of this development?
For me, it is not surprising. Because, again, we started very well. At a point, we became complacent. And the complacency is seen in the public discourse and the dissemination of information regarding coronavirus. We saw the domination of the social media, spreading half-truths, claiming all sorts of remedies, and saying that Africans and Nigerians are immune to the coronavirus. Now, at this point, this is the time to overreact. Because if we don't overreact, the consequences could be dire and serious. I mean that we need to institute other measures that will further hunker down and cool in this coronavirus challenge. We don't have the medical experts, requisite number. We don't have the hospital facilities and infrastructure like the scale we are seeing in Italy, where you have to take a very challenging decision on who to save or who not to save. So for us, at this point, we should honestly have a clear-cut understanding from the level of government how to do self-isolation, how to enforce social distancing, how to create guidelines for community in mitigating the challenges of this coronavirus. We have to do more than checking people at the airport and then isolating them. We have to do more than that as we are going now.
Dr. T,
what happened in Italy? How the case doubled within one day? They added a whole 4,000 people overnight between Saturday and Sunday. 4,000, taking their cases to more than 25,000, and they added more than 400 deaths just within a day. We should honestly be careful, and now it's time to overreact.
All right, let me ask you this. In the light of what you just said, should there be a case where there's more infection and more spread, do you think as a people we're equipped enough to curtail and isolate people? Should there be a worst-case scenario of more outbreaks and infections?
We tell you what, we don't have the requisite ability and infrastructure to isolate people. In this country, let's be factual. We don't even have ventilators. You know, our emergency rooms are challenged. We have just 100 beds in IDH, in the mainland hospital. The other states are not that prepared. Even the dialogue, the discussion is being led by social media rumors. Now, the thing is this. If I were to be state government now, let's say in a place like Lagos, I would insist that, listen, all of you having to gather and attend church or, you know, what's it called, crusade and all those things, please put them on hold. Now, in terms of school, for now, until we see a clearer picture, what can we do, you know, to look at these things? Any sports events must be put on hold. Anything that will involve people gathering more than 500 must be put on hold. We must be able to really think in that dimension because, honestly, we don't have the ability, we don't have the fund, we don't have the human resources to deal with extensive outbreak of coronavirus. It already is hurting our economy. But if we don't overreact now to this pandemic, the consequence could be worse.
We hear of countries like South Africa and Ghana, their president coming out to put restriction bans on traveling and inbound tourism. But not so much of this has been heard from our government. Do you think they're doing enough when it comes to restriction of tourism and inbound tourism to ensure we curtail the infection coming in as it is already?
It is surprising that our government is not saying something so emphatic with regards to this. Here we are. You see, let me tell you, Let nobody be deceived. You know why we're not picking so much cases of coronavirus at it where now? Nigeria is not a top tourist destination country. You know what I mean? Now, if you look at the number of flights that is moving out in and out of, say, Schiphol Airport in Amsterdam or Fiumicino in Italy, and you compare to the number of flights entering Nigeria, what goes on in that place in a week is maybe more than what goes on in Nigeria in a week. So for us, we have that advantage now. Though we are not having a lot of tourists coming to the country, we have that advantage to see that little that are coming, we do a proper checking and even limit those people for now. We need to have looked at this thing and grade those countries. And so that, let's say, are you coming from New York? Are you coming from Washington? We have to specify those cities. Are you coming from New York? Are you coming from Washington? Are you coming from South Korea? Are you coming from France, Italy? Are you coming from China? Please, you cannot come in now. Because in reality, who is going to help us? Where are we going to get the funds to fight coronavirus? Or anything is hurting our budget. We have to be so specific. If you're an indigenous of the country coming from those places, you have to be put in under special care. We can even use their phone to track them and know whether they're self-isolating. And we have to state clearly the guidelines for social distancing as this country is going now. Don't let us be deceived. You know, it's not by trying to, drink special water or recite special religious book verses. That is not the way to run a pandemic, to run down a pandemic. Even the countries that are so believe in religious and those things, they are taking actions, and we see the thing that's made them. The case of South Korea came to be because some religious people went to Wuhan for one crusade and brought the disease and in droves into South Korea, and they're suffering it. So
now
for
you
us,
did, yes, doctor, let me,
so
let me interject.
Careful to, and
let me cut you. Let me cut you in here. Sorry, if you don't mind.
To say that if you cannot come in from social countries for now,
okay,
because we don't have capability to deal with massive epidemic or pandemic of coronavirus in Nigeria.
Okay, doctor. Now we have a third case already in our hands. Now, what should be the immediate approach towards ensuring this newly reported case does not degenerate?
Again, another question is that how we must be able to ensure that we get to the point of truth where this third instance, where this third case can tell us frankly his or her contacts. You know, because the contact tracing is key. Now, you see, the world is not new to epidemic, okay? Now, when the bubonic plague came to Europe and killed more than half of the population, Poland was spared because Poland executed a very aggressive isolation system. Very aggressive. So what's the best? So now we need to figure out for this case. Yes, he's already in an hospital. He's been quarantined. He's been looked after. But where are the contacts? Where place has she gone to? How can we trace it? Can his phone help in tracing those places that have gone to? How do we now check? Because the other key is that, for us, even people in private or different hospital settings, for them to do testing for this coronavirus is quite difficult. They are not having kits. How are we spreading the testing ability to be so convenient that we can pick as many cases as possible? Because what we are seeing may be an iceberg phenomenon in such a way that we have quite a huge number of cases that we can only test very few. So, there's a challenge with testing, as it were. So we must be able to pursue what we can pursue. That is, case identification and contact tracing.
All right, quickly, doctor, before I let you go, in just 30 seconds, if you will, we've had countries, cancel sporting activities and gatherings of people, about 100 people, where they've been cancelled. Now, when you were talking earlier, you did mention about our places, our religious houses, where people gather for worship, and nothing has been said in this regard. Do you think at this point that the federal government should put a ban on gatherings of up to 100 people, which include our religious houses?
It is necessary. I sincerely think that from today, we should be able to send down the clear-cut understanding. For if you want to do your religious gathering, please do your home fellowship, as the case may be, where you have just few people gather together and do that their worship. Suspend large gathering for now. We don't understand this disease so well. We don't understand it so well. We cannot afford to be careless in this situation. Now, if God can hear you from any point, let them do teleconferencing. They have, most of them have television station where they can do preaching to their to their followers. Let them use those kind of video in such a way that people can see their comfort, their home, and watch whatever they want to watch about their general Basia. So for me, honestly, I think that is the greatest, one of the toughest place we need to do something about. People come from other parts of the world to come and attend this religious thing. They come from South Africa, they come from different parts of the world, they come from Ghana. Ghana's cases has gone from one, how many days to now? Six. And it's becoming a problem. And Ghana is just across us here. And then we're not looking at these religious places as a place that the virus can enter us. I've cited an example of South Korea, how they got that large number of cases when people went to religious pilgrimage somewhere in Wuhan, in China. So I think our government needs to be proactive. We're not doing enough. Well, I mean, let's send this one in now. Because when the virus came, the first week the virus came, and I spoke on the television station, I told them that the virus is unstoppable. I said, this virus I'm looking is unstoppable. We need to do something now. Look at it. America denied.
We have to let you go now, Dr. Tuyi Webawondu.
So we cannot allow ourselves to face this thing.
Thank you very much for joining us and for your enlightenment on News on the Hour.
Thank you.